वेलकम टू वीडियो क्लासेस ऑर्गेनाइज बाई फाउंटेन इंटरनेशनल कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट. दिस इज़ एन यूनिक मेथड ऑफ टीचिंग द स्टूडेंट्स वी आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर IIT JEE एंड PMT examinations. माई सेल्फ इज डॉक्टर राम कुमार एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू बायोलॉजी एंड टूडे टॉपिक इज पॉलिनेशन. राइट नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट पॉलिनेशन. फर्स्ट लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड who discovered pollination, that is the discoveries. So Camerarius discovered pollination in the flower of mulberry. So the credit for discovery of pollination given to Camerarius. But actually Grew first of all reported that stamen is the male sex organ of angiospermic flower. Stamen is the male sex organ of angiospermic flower, and after that Camerarius reported that carpel is the female sex organ of angiospermic flower. Carpel is the female sex organ of angiospermic flower, and in the case of sexual reproduction in higher plants, most of the works done by Camerarius, and that's why Camerarius credited for the discovery of sexual reproduction in higher plants. And this is very important question asked many times in various PMT examinations. So Camerarius is credited for the discovery of sexual reproduction in higher plants. Now I'm going to first define what is pollination. The typical definition of pollination is transference of pollen grains from anther to receptive stigma of the same flower or other flower of the same plant or different plant of same species this is the typical definition of pollination. In pollination we have defined that pollination is the transference of pollen grains. So mind it, in pollination always transference of pollen grains occur, never transference of embryo sac takes place. And during pollination, pollen grain get transferred, and pollen grain contains the male gamete, and that's why we give the symbol like this for the male gamete. And this arrow shows the direction of the movement of the pollen grains. So transference of pollen grains from anther, because pollen grains produce inside the anther, from anther to receptive stigma. Mind it, before pollination the stigma should be receptive. Receptive stigma means when astigmatic fluid gets secreted from the surface of stigma, that is after the formation of embryo sac. And before pollination the stigma should be receptive. Because one basic concept is pollination and fertilization are the simultaneous process. It means when pollination takes place or pollination occurs, it means it is going to converted into the fertilization. So before fertilization, the stigma should be receptive, and during pollination it never moves, and that's why we use the symbol of female like this. Like this means just we fix the female gamete, that is the embryo sac. So nowhere you have studied or read the definition of pollination like this, that is transference of embryo sac from ovule to anther, never. Always in pollination there is transference of pollen grains from anther to receptive stigma. Now there may be three cases. That receptive stigma may be of same flower, or that receptive stigma may be other flower of the same plant, or the third possibility is of different plant, but a species should be same. So each and every case, this process is called pollination. So first let me explain, during pollination there is transference of pollen grains. So we should know whether the pollen grain is motile structure or non-motile structure. By taking the essence of definition, it seems that pollen grains should be motile structure. But mind it, in pollination, pollinating agents are involved, and so pollen grains are not motile structure. Pollen grains are non-motile structure. Because in pollination they use different types of pollinating agents. Now the process of pollination occurs inside the flower. So on the basis of nature of flower, we should know the type of flower. On the basis of nature of flower, flowers are of two types. One is called chiasmogamous. Another one is called cleistogamous. Chiasmogamous means when flowers open fully to expose their mature sex organ for pollinating agents. In that case, the flower is called chiasmogamous. And most of the flowers are the example of the chiasmogamous, like China rose, etc. Most of the flowers are the example of the chiasmogamous. But in cleistogamous group, there are two words. Cleistos means closed, gamos means marriage. Gamos means marriage. So here we take the meaning of gamos, that is marriage, at the sex organ. So cleistogamous flower never open fully to expose their mature sex organ for pollinating agents. And typical example of cleistogamous flowers are Commelina, pea, groundnut, etc. These are the typical example of cleistogamous flower. So on the basis of flower, on the basis of nature, this classification is on the basis of nature means whether the flower is open or closed. So on the basis of nature, flower is of two types, chiasmogamous and cleistogamous. So these are the basic points.
Now all this analytical motion may be one dimension, two dimension or three dimension. As per the Newtonian mechanism, our understanding of the Newtonian physics, where time is not a dimension, x, y and z, this is the three dimension of the universe. As you see, the dimension analysis takes place with respect to the vector concept of it. And the vector concept says
these three vectors, displacement, velocity, and acceleration, they decide the understanding of motion and their conceptual formula. Such as, if the motion is in one dimension, then direction of the displacement, direction of the velocity, and direction of the acceleration, all will make angle between them either 0 degree or 180 degree between object.
That thing shows that the dimensional motion in 1D, while these three vectors will make such angles. Such as, if people understand, since you are preparing for IIT and medicals, a car is in motion, definitely the velocity of the car, directional displacement and directional acceleration in a plane road makes angle 0 degree. Same as when you throw an object in upward direction, directional velocity and directional acceleration due to gravity makes angle 180 degree. That's why if in this situation you are observing the equation v equal to u plus minus at, at that situation you are observing v equal to u plus minus gt. G is the gravitational intensity or intensity due to gravity or acceleration due to gravity. In the same manner, after considering these three vectors, displacement, velocity and acceleration, we understand two-dimensional motion. If the directional velocity and directional acceleration at a point makes angle theta, where theta lie between 0 degree to 180 degree, maybe it's 90 in between them, then you consider the motion of the object is two dimensional. If the motion takes velocity and acceleration angle at 90 degree, then we'll see that is a circular motion. And if it is varies from every point, then in between them may act at angle 90, then you consider the locus of the path of the motion is parabolic, and that is called the projectile trajectory as a parabolic motion. Similarly, if a charged particle is entering into the electromagnetic field, then that electromagnetic orientations on the charged particle gives a three-dimensional motion. In this situation, or the motion of the earth around the sun is one of the simplest part. Such situation observe directional velocity, directional acceleration and the displacement vector, and depending on angular orientation theta 1 between velocity and acceleration, theta 2 between acceleration and displacement. Orientation between them gives the particular thing. If theta 1 is not equal to theta 2 and is giving 0 to 360, then motion is considered as three-dimensional motion. But theta 1 will decide and theta 2 will decide how they can change each other. That's why the velocity, if it is 11.2 km per second to escape from the earth as escape velocity of an object, then gravitational acceleration on the same manner become only 9.8 meter per second square, and after height it also decreases. So magnitudinal fact, sometime we discuss about the understanding of this vector, but the theoretical formulas and question numericals, it comes from the simple part of your subject, that how this equation makes, how the equation put you the graph, and what is the misconcept in this system. So we'll discuss in our chapter first one dimension motion. There are two variations, uniform accelerating motion and non-uniform accelerating motion. In brief, I'll give you the whole picture of this chapter towards you, and then we'll go through the question.